Well, that's like, you know, your alarm clock in the morning. It's just something that's irritating, but it's there.
And I hope that your alarm clock isn't too irritating as it's gone off this morning at 5:02. What's going on? We got a morning mind blender.
Lisa Dent, you got one?
I found one. And I promise you that she'll be back tomorrow. I talked to her. She said she'll be back tomorrow, dude.
Okay. You talked to her?
Yeah.
You remember talking to her?
No, actually, she left me a massage.
Oh, okay. That's even better then.
Wasn't hanging out. But I do have some tickets I want to give away.
Oh, yeah. We got lots of tickets to give away this morning.
We have Leanne Rimes and Billy Gilman, who tried to get through when we had Pat Green and Corey Morrow in.
That was not Billy Gilman.
Well, you never know. Martina McBride, Leanne Womack together. We're also giving away tickets to Def Leppard. You know, you win and you pick. Barry Manilow's in there as well. I know. I tried to hang
out. You know, I think we ought to do a combined prize pack.
What's that?
The Barry Manilow, Def Leppard.
Okay.
Giving them the total opposite ends of the spectrum.
It's all your pick if you're smart enough. Check it out. Hey, men who have three or more of these a week are 50% less likely to die from coronary heart disease. Men who have three or more of these a week. What the heck is that?
Heart disease.
I know the answer.
What?
I know the answer.
Well, what? I bet you do.
I do.
Well, then just...
Can't tell you, though.
Please don't.
Because I have the right answer on this one, finally.
Cool. It's 5:03. What's going on?
The exit ramp. This 7 Kikk FM.
This is Montgomery Gentry. She couldn't change me. Houston's Country Alternative 95.7 Kikk FM. But his hubby had changed a man.
No. Things have changed around me, but the tubby hasn't changed.
The tubs are still cool?
Yeah.
Still hanging. All right, bro. You moving this weekend?
I'm not moving anywhere. I'm moving a lot of stuff around, though. Get the whole family under one roof now.
Man, I'm going to the junior commercial steer tonight.
Uh-huh.
Give away a pickup truck, a kick-up truck.
All right,
yeah. Like a very young... You know, man or woman is going to win this. We're talking 16, 17 years old, brand new truck. I think last year a female won, and she wasn't even 16 yet, so she gets to wait until she gets her license. As soon as she does,
man.
She has a brand new shiny Dodge.
Brand new truck sitting in the driveway, and you don't even have your learner's
just
permit.
For knowing how to raise, you know, if you raise them right, you win it, baby. We got them on the money. That's right, Mama.
Let's see if we got anybody on the phone that's a winner.
I do believe we have that. Here's the deal, folks. Men who have three or more of these a week, 50% less likely, actually, not more likely, less likely to die of coronary heart disease. What's your answer?
Aspirin?
Aspirin isn't right, but that's a good idea as well.
What is it, Big Joe?
I can't tell you what it is. Still got some games to play here. I know what everybody's thinking it's going to be. I bet you that's what JP was thinking. What's your guess?
I say beer.
Not beer.
No? Okay, thanks.
I bet you JP was thinking it was beer, too.
Okay.
Is that right, JP?
No.
Oh, you weren't saying?
No.
So you actually know what the answer is?
What did I tell you earlier?
Did I say I know the answer?
I know the answer.
You can hear that air of confidence in his voice.
Well, that's, you know, I always hear confidence in JP's voice.
Whether I know or not, huh?
Yeah.
Well, then I got you fooled, pal.
What's your guess?
Would it be fruits?
Fruits isn't right.
Okay. Thank you.
Hey, who's this?
It's Steve.
Be cool, Steve.
All right, buddy.
Have a good morning. Everybody have a good morning. Welcome, and I do promise, Lisa did tell me on the massage, she will be back tomorrow. It is her own show, folks. And I'm sorry for messing with you. I was just having fun, seeing she wasn't going to be around. What's your guess?
I was going to get 3 glasses of wine.
Wine?
Wine's fine, but liquor's quicker, sir.
That's right. You are incorrect.
Thank you.
No, well, thank you very much.
No, thank you.
Well, Tubby, you deserve a lot of the thanks as well.
Thank you, JP. Is your mama dance?
It's Loggins, Messina, Kikk FM. Your mama don't dance. Yeah, it's the Lisa Dent Show. You better believe it. She'll be back in full force tomorrow, so look out. Here comes your cup of coffee.
She's home hanging out with her dad. She isn't feeling so well.
Got that right. We got a morning mind bender. Trying to give away some Leanne Rimes, Billy Gilman. They are together, as well as Leanne Romack. Martina McBride. They're hanging out together as well.
Spit it out, Joe.
Jim Train. Def Leppard, Barry Manilow. Sounds interesting. We got those to choose from, too. Come on. We call it the morning mind bender, and here's the deal. Men who have three or more of these, this thing. 50% less likely to die of coronary heart failure. Come on, what is your guess?
Sex.
What?
Sex.
Sex is not good. Well, wait a second. Let's rethink that.
Joe,
actually, it's pretty
Joe,
good.
I know you gave up, you know, the booze for Lent.
Yes.
Today is your start, you know.
Well, yeah, I know.
Yeah.
I know. I'm going to go to get some ashes put on my forehead, I believe. Hey, what's your guess to this morning, Mind Bender?
I don't know. I was going to ask you, was it something you consume?
No.
Well, what's the answer?
What?
What's your guess?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I don't know. Shit. I was going to say wine, but the guy had already said wine.
We'll take another guess.
A big fat cigar or some shit.
Cut him off, man.
Joe.
A little potty mouth there.
Yeah. He's been cut off, man. Come on.
I don't know, man. Some, man.
A big fatty.
JP, is this as painful to you because you've been waiting and sitting on the answer the whole time?
It's very painful.
All right, guys. Actually, trying to do you a favor and give you rodeo
tickets. Kind of nice, but painful.
Anyway, yeah, there you go. Hey.
Alert.
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 All right, here's the deal, folks. Three or more of these for men will result in a 50% chance of less likely death of... Here, how did I word that again, Tubby?
They won't die of a heart attack.
Ow! What's your guess?
Morning.
Well, what's going on?
Well, I got your answer for you.
What is it?
If not, it's a good answer anyway.
Okay.
Is it orgasms?
Ba-boom!
We got us a winner.
Or a wiener. Hey, man, you get your pick. You want Leon Rimes, Billy Gilman, or would you like Martina Leon Womack, Def Leppard, Barry Manilow? Come on.
Oh, man. Run that by me again.
Okay, this morning, sir, we have Martina McBride and Leon Womack, Def Leppard, Barry Manilow, or Leon Rimes and Billy Gilman. What I'm going to do for you today, sir, is I'm going to give you a two-for-one offer. I will give you the Def Leppard and Barry Manilow as a...
When is Def Leppard and Barry Manilow?
Def Leppard is tomorrow night, and Barry Manilow is Saturday night.
Is... okay. I work night. What do you got for...
How about Sunday night, March 4th, Leanne Rimes, Billy Gilman?
That'll work.
Woo, that was painful. What's your name?
Jay.
Right on, Jay. Hang on. Man, I'm a little late doing this part. I'm sorry, everybody. Are you in a hurry? Are you trying to get to work by 5:30? I hope not. It's 5:20. What's going on, dude?
This part of the Lisa Dent Morning Show brought to you by Memorial Hermann Hospital.
It's a fisherman's paradise, the 26th annual fishing show.
Hey, Tubby here telling you I found a new way. Well, not a new way. I found the way to lose weight. That's why you sleep. Can't beat that. I'm losing weight while I'm sleeping, all because of Body Solutions. That's right. 2 weeks ago, started on Body Solutions, and 2.5 weeks now. I started on Monday. Started on Body Solutions. I am down 12 pounds, and I'm doing it all while I'm sleeping. Not changing really what I'm eating. Feeling a lot better because of it. And you can do the same by dialing 1-800-416-3995. That's 1-800-416-3995. Body Solutions. I'm losing while I'm sleeping. So can you. Give them a call. 1-800-416-3995. Lose weight with Body Solutions.
Hey, this is Kat, and you know what I'm going to
do? No matter where they come from, as long as they're coming.
I hear you. We all have a good one.
You too. Hey, it is the Lisa Dent Show. Fear not, as she returns tomorrow to her very own program. Very glad that you kept her in your thoughts and prayers. David Lindley, heard of him, you are right now. It's Mercury Blues at Houston's Country Alternative. It's Kikk FM, mama. Wow, that rocked. That was David Lindley, Mercury Blues. I want to play that again.
You do?
Yeah. Should we? Here, hold on. Everybody slow down. Stop it, for Pete's sakes.
Wow. You had your headphones cranked.
I know, I was jamming.
Jamming to it.
Anyhow, the Lisa Dent program returns tomorrow. JP News and Traffic.
We're doing the Lisa Dent program right now.
Well, we're trying. It isn't easy, Tubby. I'm ashamed to even call it that. I can't say welcome to the Lisa Dent program.
Especially when you're playing the same song twice.
And JP's got your news and traffic coming up next. Welcome and good morning. It's Kikk-Fm. It's Kikk-Fm.
This is...
Oh, yeah. 534, JP, what's going on, dude?
A Houston high school principal is being accused of trying to manipulate his students' scores on the state TUS test. That's a big no-no. In order to make the results look better than they are. Students and teachers claim that Robert Worthy, principal of Kikk-Fm.
Toby Keith, check this out, Tuff. That's right. And who else has six? Oh, come on. Come on, Snappy. Come on, Snappy. All right. Talking about the Country Music Awards, baby. May 9th, CBS. Big show. Toby Keith, Kikk-Fm.
Where the man said it might storm today. I gotta get to feel, gotta bear some hand. Can't let it rain on my daddy farm. Get it all stacked up high and long. And I'm gonna call my baby, she's been waiting on me. Yeah, she lives downtown on Sycamore Street.
Wow! Tubby, that's how you get nominated for six awards.
We were jamming.
We were, man. I was jamming.
I just love that song.
It is a good one.
You know, I used to play with hillbilly girls. You I married one. Well, actually, I married a country chick.
How's the tamstress?
Stress is the key word there.
Well, is she okay? What's wrong, man? Well, the whole, you know, getting
somebody's
the house
moved
ready for
her cheese, you know, so.
Understood, man. I heard the word.
You know, but it's all going to get better here soon.
Your mama dances, doesn't she? She like to dance?
Yeah. But my daddy don't rock and roll.
Oh, what a shame.
My dad is a country boy.
Hey, could everybody please join us? Lisa returns tomorrow. She'd love to see you. She would really love to see you at the Road Trip for Charity Saltgrass Tomball, 11:30 to 1, our last chance to help out SNAP. Speaking of SNAP.
Spay and neuter assistance program. Speaking of SNAP, a big supporter of SNAP is another Lisa. Lisa Ferranda.
She's going to be hanging out today.
Well, she's going to be calling in, checking in with us, Joe.
Well, that's cool, man. Good enough. A phone call from Lisa Ferranda is better than
one from Greg Hurst.
Okay.
Oh, Greg's cool, too. I mean, he's a cool guy. But come on. Now,
you know. Well, yeah, he is. He's a good guy. Nah.
Yeah, he's all right.
This is KT Oslin. You know what I'm talking about. WKT Oslin. Live close by. Visit often, baby. Kikk-Fm.
I love you, baby.
Good morning. Welcome to the Lisa Dent Show. It's Kikk-Fm. You know it to be Houston's country alternative at 95.7. My name's Lil Joe.
I'm Tubby.
JP's hanging.
What's up?
Dude, just chilling. President talked yesterday. You know that. Did you watch it?
Yeah, I actually did see about... I had a T-ball practice last night, actually.
Oh, cool.
Not for myself, of course, but... For my little one.
Sure, JP.
And I happen to be managing the T-ball team. That's what you do when you get old and be a dad.
Who are you? I'm the manager.
That's right. Manager of what, sir?
What age T-ball are the kids?
Four.
T-ball. Oh, man, four. That's got to be a great experience. You bet you have a lot of patience there, JP.
Well, you have to have a lot of patience, yes. Yes, that's the key. But anyway, I did get to see about, 15, maybe 20 minutes in between, you know, baths and dinner and all that kind of stuff. And I was pretty impressed with his confidence in sticking to, the stuff that he campaigned on.
Yeah,
he says he's going to do it.
He's sucking in the Democrats, though. You know, he's pulling up part of their platform and saying, okay, we're going to do this now just to appease you guys. But
Hey, you keep your friends close, your enemies closer.
That's right. And you know what? What really bothered me, though, is as much as he's trying to appease them in doing certain things, every time they cut to a crowd shot and show the Democrats, they're like, yeah, whatever.
Yeah, they're all sitting there with their arms crossed.
Everybody's standing ovation. Oh, yeah, baby, you rock.
Bush rocks, yeah.
Ted Kennedy.
Yeah, whatever.
They're all looking like, can I just get out of here?
Ted was just looking for that fifth of vodka that was rolling around under his seat.
Hey, I'm not looking. It's Doug Vig. It's Ash Wednesday. I've quit.
And how was your little get-down throwdown last night?
Oh, man, it sucked.
Apparently, it must have been pretty good yesterday afternoon.
Jeez, I'm embarrassed that we even sent listeners to that party. It was really lame. And I think they thought the same because I showed up. I walked around, couldn't find a one of them, and I said, let's get out of this party.
Really?
What about the afternoon party? That was the one.
Oh, Pat Green, Corey Morrow, my Lord. JP, it was huge, baby. We're talking, I think they had more than 600 folks crammed inside Cactus Music. Everybody showed up
free
to
beer,
watch.
Free pizza. They're there.
Oh, man. To be quite honest, they were more in line to buy and get signings. And those guys were joking around, having a good time.
Oh, those guys were just like us.
Pat Green, Corey Morrow, that was a blast having them on yesterday. They did a great show. You did a good job to get there and see it. If you did, you have something to talk about because that was a lot of fun. And the MTV Wanna Be a VJ guy showed up.
Oh,
JR
did he?
Showed
JR,
up.
Yeah.
So I met him.
I missed the whole thing, but I had to go home and finish hanging sheetrock.
Definitely a good time. He had to hang sheetrock, didn't he?
Tubby, he's becoming so domesticated.
That's
now.
Right. He has two wives, he was telling me, JP. Now he's got his wife and his new stepdaughter, Brittany, to answer to as well. It's 549. What's going on?
45 northbound entry. 95.7.
I was thinking quite possibly giving away rodeo tickets now. If you want to play back and forth, I'll take caller 10 and caller 11. I'll put you up against each other and see who wins. It's back and forth with Kikk-Fm, baby. Building a mystery. Sarah McLachlan, 95.7 Kikk-Fm, yes.
Houston's country alternative.
Yes.
Hey, was that Sarah McLachlan?
Yeah, it was.
Kikk-Fm.
Okay.
Okay.
Joe trying to get that smooth jazz thing going.
No, I'm trying to do NPR and it ain't working.
Okay.
NPR is more like this.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Isn't it, though?
Yes, it is. You would be correct in assuming so, sir. Hey, did y'all, I heard you say, like, Toby Keith has, like, 6 nominations.
Yes, he does.
Yeah, Leanne's got 5.
Leanne?
Yeah.
Wait a second.
Let's see, you know, whoever you're talking to or getting your information from, pal, they're scamming you.
Hey, wait a second. USA Today right here says Leanne Womack and Toby Keith led nominees for the 36.
Exactly. Led
with
nominees.
6 nods apiece.
No.
That's what it says, man.
Toby Keith, this is straight off the wire. Toby Keith leads nominees with 6.
Do you believe what's on the wire?
No, I'm just reading it. Okay. Leanne Womack, a close runner-up with 5 ACM nods to her name.
My research here says 6 each, too. Let's see here.
You know what? What we need to do is track down some names.
That's right.
I want some butts.
Well, I got it right here. Toby Keith nominated for Entertainer of the Year, Top Male Vocalist. Okay. Top Female Vocalist. There's Leanne right there.
Hey, Dennis.
Yeah?
You give a rat's butt?
Not really.
Hey, JP.
Yeah.
Phyllis show up with any breakfast for you yet?
No, why?
Well, I was sitting here hungry.
That's right. Dennis and Patricia. Yeah.
How's it going, Lil Joe?
Everything's cool. I'm just hoping Patricia's still... Patricia, you there, baby?
Yeah, I'm here.
All right, girl. All right.
Go back
you ready to play, Patricia?
Sure.
Let me hear you scream, Patricia. All right, that's good enough. Here we go. It's called Back and Forth. I tried to explain. I don't know if I did it good enough.
Joe, it's Back and Forth.
And here's the deal. I'm going to throw out a topic like McDonald's, and Tubby and I were playing, and I start off with the Hamburglar.
French fries.
Big Mac.
Shake.
Shake.
Yeah.
See, he stumped me. I don't know why. See, I'm hungry. And he won because I couldn't have come up with anything.
You couldn't come up with chicken McNuggets, filet fish sandwich.
A shake quarter salad, is that what
cheese.
They call them? I don't know. Hand toss?
Salad shaker.
I don't know what the heck's going on at fast food joints anymore, Tubby. Dennis, Patricia, here's the deal. We're hungry. We're talking about breakfast. We'd really like some. Rhonda, what's going on? Good morning. Good morning.
Breakfast foods.
Breakfast foods. That's your topic. You're going for rodeo tickets, all right?
All right.
Dennis, you called first. You're caller 10. You go first. Breakfast foods, go.
Eggs. Sausage.
Oh, boom. Bam.
Wow.
Dennis, she just said sausage.
I didn't hear it.
Oh, man, she did. I promise. I got to call you that you lost, man.
Oh, bummer.
I'm sorry, dude. She had just said sausage and you repeated her. Patricia, what do you want to go see? Martina, Leanne Womack? I'm sorry, man.
That would go on forever. Breakfast food. You can have pancakes.
Sausage.
Somebody's got sausage on the brain.
Man, everybody's hungry. I'm sorry, Dennis. We'll play again later.
All right.
Def Leppard, Barry Manilow. What you want, Patricia?
Martina McBride.
All right, hang on the line. Tubby's got to get some info from you. JP's got to get his info for you because he's delivering it next at Kikk FM.
If this is your life.
Drive, gym, workshop, phone, lunch, carpool, shoe sales suck.
You got to hang on. JP, what's going on?
Well, news if you want it.
605, give it to me.
This update is the service of Albert.
John Mellencamp, formerly John Cougar, also formerly John Cougar Mellencamp. It's the Cherry Bomb at Houston's Country Alternative. Good morning and thanks for joining us.
You are the bomb, Joe.
Whoa, hey.
Yeah, what's up, man?
Kikk FM.
Good morning, honey.
Hey, baby.
What's going on?
Nothing, just missing you.
Hey, Tubby.
Good morning, honey.
How are you?
Oh, wait, no.
Hey,
good morning, honey. Well, I was just getting ready to call Tammy, so, you know.
Wake up call.
Yeah.
How are you feeling, babe?
Everything's great. I feel fine. How about we all call Tammy right now?
Okay.
Okay, hold on, baby.
Thanks.
By the way.
You might want to pot that down.
Thunderstorm.
21. Yeah, 286. Down, down, down.
There you go. There
you haven't got her moved yet?
No.
Oh, I thought that was last weekend.
No. We were originally going to do it the 15th. Now we're moving it up to... We're going to move part over this weekend, part next weekend.
Hello.
Good morning. What's going on, Tammy?
Nothing much. Did you bring him breakfast?
Not yet. I was calling to see what the punks wanted.
Oh, yeah!
Geez, baby, would you have time maybe to bring some food over to JP's Bees?
I don't know where that is.
Good. I don't think you really have time to do it.
No,
anyway.
I don't think you do either. Besides,
he doesn't deserve it. He got cake.
That's what? Right.
Oh my
cake
God.
Eater.
Yeah. From not even his girl.
I know.
His wife didn't even make it. He's accepting food from another woman.
Well, it's his surrogate mother, you know.
Oh,
I have that Phyllis. Effect on women.
Phyllis.
I could have sworn the answer this morning was a visit to Home Depot.
To the morning mind bender?
To the morning mind bender.
Because that's all the time that Tubby spends all his time there now.
Really, I'm probably doing that more than the others so far.
How's
the
room coming along?
Almost finished.
Cool.
Baby, I would love fluffy eggs, toast, hash browns, all that good stuff.
From where?
From the fluffiest egg place
well,
you can
find. Well, last night you said McDonald's.
That's good.
Yeah,
that's
that'll good. Work.
We'll take it.
You'd love $1 million too, little Joe.
All right, let's end that phone call right about there.
Hey, guys, I'm counting. You ready?
Yeah.
Top female vocalist.
Yeah.
Hey, wait.
Vocal event of the year.
Hey, here it is. Top female vocalist. Yes, that's top, number one.
Okay. Okay. Vocal event of the year.
Vocal event of the year.
Song of the year.
Song of the year.
Single of the year.
Single of the year.
Album of the year.
Album of the year.
Video of the year.
Video of the year.
That's six.
That's it. Is that six?
Yeah, that's six. Count them up, JP.
Well, then never mind already, okay?
Just go back to your little wire service.
It's cool, my brother from yet another mother. It is 6:16. What's happening, dude?
More of Joe's quick wit. Love it. 45 northbound entrance ramp from St. Joseph's and Pease now open from earlier construction. Northbound exit ramp to Houston.
Best friend, CBS Tonight.
Hey, I could be a macho man. I will be soon. I'm down 12 pounds in a little over 2.5 weeks now. And it's all because of Body Solutions. That's right. I'm losing weight while I sleep. Of course, hanging sheetrock doesn't, you know, kind of burns off some of it. But that's the thing with Body Solutions, though. After you start to lose the weight, you start to get energized. You feel like you can do more. I even had thoughts of joining a gym. Jeez, I haven't done that in forever. It's all because of Body Solutions. You can do the same by dialing 1-800-416-3995. That's 1-800-416-3995. This is not your typical diet program because it's not a diet program. You don't have to change what you're eating. Just eat, you know, after 6. Well, mine's after 6 o'clock at night because I usually go to bed by 9. And I take my little Body Solutions and I'm getting slimmer as I sleep. And you can do the same as the Tubster is. 1-800-416-3995.
If you're like most...
Dwight the Tight. Right here at Kikk FM. Bye-bye.
Hey, he's hosting.
He's doing what?
He's hosting.
Oh, man, that. Entertainment, the CMAs, baby. Kikk FM.
Dwight Yoakam on 95.7 Kikk FM, Houston's country alternative. And I misspoke. Dwight Yoakam is not hosting. He was one of the ones that made the announcements of who the nominees were yesterday along. Dwight Yoakam and Billy Bob Thornton.
You got that
is
right.
Is that a mismatch there or what?
Hey, I kind of like it. No, it isn't. They are buddies.
Well,
man.
I'm sure, but I mean, you know, it's just like right. You and I. That's a Mutt and Jeff couple right there, you know, a couple of Mutt and Jeff dudes.
Hey, JP, I was reading, I didn't get to watch it, but I read that the president, you know, delivers well, he spoke well. Not necessarily that you have to agree with everything he said, but I heard that he did a good job speaking and that he was quite humorous as well.
You know, the part that I saw, he's, as the critics put it, very presidential. He commands respect in the same sentence as he's sincere. So
and he pulled it off all right, huh?
Yeah,
he does a good job. Have you always thought he was a good speaker yourself, or have you never? Really
I don't think he's really that good of a speaker, okay. So to speak. But I mean, he holds his own. I mean, he was supposed to. You have to remember, this guy was supposed to lose every single debate. Presidential debate with Al Gore, because Al Gore is like this big, was it Harvard or Yale? Like captain and connoisseur. I mean, this guy was supposed to be the debater of all debaters.
Hey, watch yourself. Hey,
yeah, because he could be the master debater.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I guess you're right. In Recollect, I read up, they did say that he spoke well, but you're right, that when they would compare him to President Clinton, of course, well, he wasn't that good, but he did better than everybody said, because I guess nobody expected him, like you said.
Exactly. Expected him to get blown out of the water in all the debates.
Man, I wish I would have saw it. Was it ridiculously interrupted with applause?
It was at certain points, but the guy spoke statements that... you know, called for applause. I mean, you have to understand, these people are excited that they have someone, in their words, that has character, that has good moral foundation, and is supposedly going to get this country back on the right track. And he's starting with a tax break for every single person in the United States that pays taxes.
Well, hold on.
We're all for that, aren't we? Yes. All right.
There's actually going to be certain people with low income that won't pay any tax at all.
What? One more time on that? No tax at all?
There's actually... hold it.
Hold on. Everybody calm down.
There's actually people in certain income brackets that will... Not, I believe it's the $25,000 a year four-member family earning $25,000, I believe, or less, will actually pay no taxes whatsoever.
Man, this is weird. I'm learning something.
Trip. Watch TV every now and then. News on TV.
You got
okay,
that right.
Now, on to the big thing.
Mm-hmm. What's that?
JP, you're managing the 4-year-old T-ball team.
We are officially the Astros. Under the trademark of the Astros, we're going to have their uniform, their hats.
Okay. Who's your big hitter?
All right. Oh, who's my big hitter?
Yeah.
My kid.
Your kid?
Yeah. Well, my kid and the other assistant coach's kid.
And the other assistant coach's kid. And it's pitcher and catcher or pitcher and first base?
No, it's actually...
Oh, it's T-ball.
Yeah, T-ball. That would be a ball on the tee, Joe.
That's
no
right.
Catcher.
Well, but they still have the position held, right?
They do have someone out on the pitcher's mound. You are correct, sir.
Yes, you are correct, sir.
And I knocked a couple dingers in T-ball. I did.
Well, it's an interesting game because basically it's like most of these kids have never even held a bat before, much less a glove.
Yeah.
And so when they hit, the excitement level is just like way up there.
Yeah, yeah.
And usually they never run to first base first.
Yeah.
No.
They run to the pitcher's mound.
Either that or I turn around and smile at mom and go, see what I did?
And then throw the bat and ding somebody right in the head.
Oh, no. Yeah. Speaking of which, I saw a dad working with his son the other day on T-ball, and he was setting the ball back on the tee.
Mm-hmm.
The kid was a little excited, swung and hit his old man in the hand.
Yeah, I saw a few of those episodes as well.
That can happen.
Hey, JP might have more on the presidential debate. Brent, what the heck? The press at the
address of the
address to Congress.
Thanks, man. Next Kikk FM.
This is.
As a required member FDIC.
He's informed and he's going to give you the goods. It's JP at 6:34.
And this update is the service of Man Berkeley.
Ronnie Crow, maybe. Little Johnny Cash as well. Walking the line, baby. Kikk FM. Good morning.
Houston's country alternative.
95.7 Kikk FM. Johnny Cash made it home in time to celebrate his 69th birthday.
Oh, did he get home?
On Monday, yes.
So. Cool. Poor guy wasn't doing good, was it? Pneumonia, right?
Yeah. Along with other complications.
Did you just tell me he's 69?
69.
Excellent.
And he's also making plans to start work on his next album project.
Man, you just keep going when you're in country music. It just doesn't stop. I mean, you do it till you die, I guess, huh?
I guess so.
Can you give me some salt for these eggs, please?
What?
Okay, thanks. Hey, JP.
Oh, hey, what's going on, guys?
Do not even.
What?
Did Phyllis bring you eggs this morning?
No.
Who brought you food?
You're making
Oh, you
me
mean
sick.
Bring me food?
Yeah.
Yeah, Phyllis brought me some eggs and some sausage and biscuits.
Phyllis.
What's up, guys?
I cannot wait. What is up, guys?
How's it going?
Hey, JP, does your wife listen to the show by chance?
Do you get a little jealous that another woman's treating you like this?
She's not up to sort.
Oh, God.
JP's got it worked out with little Miss Phyllis.
This is terrible.
I'm sick, aren't I?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you know what?
You've ruined my mood.
These eggs are good.
All right.
And we're still wondering where our breakfast is.
Hey, I was going to tell you something else.
Yeah, I bet you were.
Just 2 points that I wanted to make on...
2 points.
On the presidential thing last night, the address to Congress.
Uh-huh.
He said two things that that made an impression on the entire audience, Democrat or Republican. And when he said... The second thing he actually said was that what it boils down to is a surplus... needs to go back to the people, or the surplus is not the government's, it's the American people's money. And everybody, including Senator Joe Lieberman, who was the vice presidential candidate for Al Gore, as you remember.
Freaked.
Stood up, was just going, this guy is good, man. You know what I'm saying? The first thing he said that was pretty cool, and he kind of let you know that he's just a smart guy, and he just wants to make everybody get along and work together to make it a better country. He said, some people think this tax cut's too big. Clap, 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 clap from the Democrats. Some people think this tax cut's too small. Clap, clap, clap from the Republicans. I think it's just right. Okay. Clap, clap, clap from everybody. Everybody's doing it. Yeah, all right, all right.
I love it. Are you on your way to work at 6:45? JP, what's happening?
Well, we're checking some of the freeways for delays or accidents for you.
Sweet Child O' Mine. Joe Crow. Stealing it from Guns N' Roses in your ear in the alternative pick. Very good, Tubby. Congratulations. Hey,
I was doing my Axl Rose impersonation.
Beautiful. Houston's country alternative. It's 95.7 Kikk FM. And, of course, it's the Lisa Dent Show. She's away visiting the folks as her father's not doing so well. So keep her and her family in your thoughts and prayers. I know she appreciates that. She wanted me to pass that on to you.
No. The general manager wanted you to pass that on.
What do you mean?
You got in a little hot water
Well,
yesterday.
Sure. I was just having fun.
Being the little Joe prankster that he is.
I was just having fun. It is the Lisa Dent Show. However, today we will have Lisa Fronda on the air. We'll have her on before 7:30, folks. Excited about that from CBS News right here in Houston.
K-H-O-U, yes, baby!
95.7 Kikk FM, yes, it is the Lisa Dent Show. She is returning tomorrow. I promise you that. J.P. Spees, he's going to have your news and traffic coming up next. Good morning and welcome to Kikk FM.
Have you noticed?
His name is J.P. Spees. He's here to inform you. Do you know what's going on? Probably not.
Yes, I do.
At 7:00. Oh, well, I didn't mean it to you. I meant that collectively.
Oh, you mean them.
Because they haven't.
Those people out there. Yes, that's why I'm here, to inform.
Yeah, you know it.
It's one of these nights.
Surely it should be.
Yeah.
Last night, geez, my send-off party turned out to be a pretty freaky little thing. We didn't stick around too long, did we, Rhonda? I looked for the winners, the listeners there. They probably thought the same thing, because I walked around for about 45 minutes, didn't see a soul that looked like one of our...
Eggs.
Oh, that's good.
Right.
Hey, Rhonda, thanks for the food. Appreciate that. Eagles, Houston's country alternative, Kikk FM. Houston's country alternative, the Eagles, with one of these nights. It is the Lisa Dent Show. Quit your panicking, people. I was joking, of course. My name is Little Joe. You should come to expect that from me. Trick Pony. Poor me. Kikk FM. Good morning. And I do believe Lisa Fronda is coming up shortly, Tubby.
Yes.
I'm excited about this. And, you know, I get a little nervous. I don't know. JP, would you too? I mean, we're talking about a true pro here.
Well,
Lisa Fronda.
Well, I wouldn't be as nervous as you.
Okay.
Because I wouldn't be hitting on her. Anyway.
Not only that, but JP, you know, he's a true pro, too.
Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. But I still wouldn't hit her, you know. Like you did. What was the what was the Channel 2 girl that you hit on?
Garza?
Cindy Garza.
Yeah.
Well, actually, he wasn't hitting on her. I believe she was doing a little hitting on him.
Yeah, that's the way he'll tell him down at the bar tonight, isn't it?
Well, no, he won't be at the bar tonight.
Oh, that's right.
Delay off.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Everybody just get off of my back. Actually, I'm excited about this. I'm really stoked.
I can tell.
Stop laughing, man. I'm
a little on edge.
I'm serious, man. I'm doing it. Today, obviously, kicked it off. I think I had my last drink around, 11 o'clock last night, baby? And
he's not talking to me.
Rhonda's
in the studio.
Are you calling Tubby baby now? It's already affecting your brain, dude.
Somebody give that kid a beer. Yeah. No, but I am. I'm stoked. I'm really excited about this whole venture. I am, man. I really am. I don't know why.
We're letting somebody out. Little Joe, in honor of Lent, has decided to give up any alcoholic beverages.
All alcohol.
Let's throw in the word try.
Okay. Yeah, we should.
Decided to try to give up alcohol.
That would be a wise word.
You know, I think he will do it because I see the look in his eye. He's really excited about this, JP. I think he was looking for a reason.
Yeah, give me a good reason
his,
to stop.
Alcoholic consumption.
I think we should do like a running update. Okay, like day three.
Either that or what we should do is a poll.
Yeah, we'll get in. And then you'd have to trust me, to be honest. And I think I could pull that off. I could think, you know,
unless you really got drunk and then you couldn't figure out what time you went off the wagon.
Day three, day four would probably be pretty boring. He'd be, oh, yeah, this is fine, la, la, la. I want to hear day 27. You know, where he's got like a 6 o'clock shadow and he's going, what, man? What do you want?
I'm really not looking forward to that. I can already feel it coming, to be honest with you. I know that day is coming, definitely, but I'm excited about it. And I went to the doctor, Dr. Steve Mahoney, my old buddy. He's doing the same thing. He said, it just wasn't because I heard you say it on the air. He says, I'm doing the same thing, giving it up too. Looking forward to saving some money, he said. I said, me too. I got bills to pay. I think this is going to save me a bazillion. Giving it up, I'm kicking it to the curb at 716. What's going on, bro?
45, the North Freeway, northbound entrance ramp.
Lisa Ferranda, I do believe she is here. Oh.
On the phone.
That's right. It's an interview with Lisa Ferranda. I'm so glad you're here. And Lisa, I'm hearing that you're having great success. Congratulations on being the number one news station in Houston. Lisa Ferranda with us here.
Thank you very much. We've been working very hard. It's been a long climb for us, but we're excited about where we are. And we just want to keep cranking out some good products. And doing a good job here in the community.
Good. Lisa, I'm so glad you're there. And I'm sorry. I know you probably try to get away from the fact that you're a very good-looking young lady. But I'm glad you're there because every day I have to hear from my main girl here at the station, Lisa Dent, go on and on and on and on about who, Tubby?
Lisa Ferranda.
No, of course.
Of course, Greg Hurst.
Well, yes. You know, Greg's a nice guy. Greg's an attractive man. And He's kind of the whole package all put together.
Yeah, okay, so you're hot for him too, huh?
Well, I respect Greg, I really do. He's a good guy, he's taught me a lot, and I've really enjoyed working with him.
And he's a hometown boy.
He is from Dallas, yes, he's from Texas.
Or local at least, okay.
Yeah, local, you know, we won't hold it against him. So,
and you're not too far away, being from Florida. Do you ever dream about going home and working, or do you want to make Houston your home?
Well, I did work at home. I came from Florida. And I started actually in Texas back in the day in San Angelo and went to Florida and then came back here. So I'm happy being in Houston right now. It's been a great place to me. The people here have been wonderful. And, of course, the food, you know, the food's great.
The food is great and it's everywhere 24 hours a day.
Yes, it is. Anytime you want to eat, anything you want to eat, it's there for you.
I'm sure you know this. I think it was the USA Today or Fitness Magazine marked us the fattest city.
In the United
States.
But
well, you know, when you have good food, you can't help but eat it.
That's
well,
right.
Lisa, I don't think we have to worry about you packing on any of the pounds because you're running, what, your sixth or seventh marathon now?
Oh, gosh. I guess I'm training for my seventh right now. That's right.
Oh, man.
How do you find time to train when you're always on TV?
Well, you just squeeze it in. I love to do it. I like running. And
people tell me it's a high. Is that true?
Well, you get it eventually, or maybe it's just delirium when it gets so hot here. You know, you're losing your mind. So, but it's a nice activity for me. I enjoy doing it. I enjoy challenging myself.
I enjoy you being on the show. We'll have more with Lisa Ferranda right after this. It's Robert Earl Keane, Houston's Country Alternative, 95.7 Kikk FM. Good morning, y'all.
But outside, it works for me. His name is Mariano. He
cuts and trims the grass for me, makes the flowers bloom. He says that he comes from a place not far from Guanajuato. It's 2 days on a bus from here, a lifetime from this room. I fix his meals and talk to him in my old broken Spanish.
Robert O'Keefe, Houston's Country Alternative, it's 95.7 Kikk-Fm. Good morning, and it is the Lisa Dent Show. However, my name is Lil Joe. Don't be confused if you're just back in town. Just tuning us back in. Lisa Dent is gone. She's away visiting her father, who isn't feeling too well. So if you keep her in your thoughts and prayers, she appreciates that. I promise you, she'll return tomorrow. So your alarm clock will sound a lot different. Hope that makes you happy. Hey, Lisa Fronda, though, is on the phone. We got another Lisa. And I was just talking to Tubby about the Spay and Neuter Assistance Program being our charity of the month. I know you're involved. It's a great program.
Oh, that's great. I'm thrilled. SNAP is one of my big charities, and I volunteer for them every week. So that's wonderful.
I was kind of offended, though, by the whole neuter scooter for a nickel. You know, now, could it have at least been a dime? These poor cats, they've got to be worth a little bit more than a nickel.
Well, the thing is, just look at it this way. The cats are worth more than a nickel, especially to their owners. I mean, a lot of them are priceless, but there are a lot of people who, even that is going to be a lot of money. And the fact that they're even offering it at that, it's good they're offering it at that low price. A penny. SNAP usually offers stuff for free.
And they're great folks, really,
yeah,
to work
they're
with.
They're wonderful.
Didn't they tell us, like, over the span of 6 years,
One male and one female cat will produce just a ridiculous amount of cats.
Like 60,
yeah, you have to get up the math
something.
Calculator for that one.
Yeah, but it's absurd, and it really puts things into perspective. So we're really appreciating their help and spreading the word about taking care of the overpopulation.
Yeah, it's funny you mention that because I'm sitting here, and one of my cats is coming, and she's sitting here in my lap. So.
I was going to ask, well, how many pets do you have, Lisa?
I have a couple.
A couple.
So I've been very fortunate. I love dogs and cats, so I've gotten very lucky and been blessed.
Well, I'm just curious, what's going on the news tonight?
Oh, we're going to be talking about something that just about everybody in this town has, cell phones.
Oh, and you know what? It's really getting on my nerves because it's always stuck to their head and they're always cutting me. They don't even know what they're doing, it seems to me.
If you see somebody weaving around on the freeway or going 45 in the fast lane, 9 times out of 10, they're talking on the phone. And they always slow down when they get to the really important part.
So what's going on?
I know, because they're talking.
Yes.
But the thing of it is, cell phones, because they're so convenient, are often used when people are committing crimes.
Oh.
You know? And this is something that police officers and investigators are starting to look for. You know, cell phone records are trying to solve crimes. So the problem is, it's not always easy to get those records. And sometimes that holdup can prevent crimes from being solved. So that's something the defenders are going to be looking at.
10 o'clock tonight, CBS. It's Lisa Fronda, JP. He's going to give you his version of the news coming up next at Kikk-Fm. Good morning.
Do you know you can have internet access from everyone's internet for just $10?
The voice of wisdom is right here at 7:35. What is happening anyway?
This update is the service of Man Berkeley, Lil Joe. Waller County authorities hope they've put an end to a gang-related crime.
Home office furniture.